أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم Chapter 2 Verse 6 Lesson 24 The Non-Believers Surah Al-Baqarah بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم As for the disbelievers, whether thou warn them or thou warn them not, it is all one for them. They believe not. Kafaruu, those who deny the truth, who refuse, who do not believe in the omnipotence of God. This word has been derived from kafara, which means to hide. According to the divine law of the religion, he is the infidel who opposes and denies the truth, who does not believe in God and his messenger, peace be upon him. While God Almighty has described about the success and condition of the persons who feared Allah and succeeded, then it is also necessary to discuss the consequence and condition of the disbelievers so that the difference among the two may be cleared and the dignity of the pious and abstinent people is illuminated. From this verse, now it is the beginnings of the mention about those people who are totally opposite to the believers. They are enemies of Islam heartily and spend their energy, wealth and time, even everything against Islam. Such people resist due to their infidelity, despite in the existence of so clear proofs. Their ability to accept the truth is being weak day by day due to successive opposing and continuous denial, even that it goes to the end entirely. In this form, threatening them or otherwise from the punishment is equal for the messenger. Grace, glory, blessings and peace be upon him. Main desire of the messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam was that the entire people should enter in the circle of Islam. In this verse, the fact has been cleared before the messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam that those people have destroyed their power of recognizing and believing in the just. As God Almighty has commanded, whether thou warn them or thou warn them not, it is all one for them. They believe not. This news is not a form of decision, but it is an announcement and declaration against the result of their continuous enmity and refusal. Allah Almighty has put the virtue of accepting the truth in every individual, but the people who oppose the truth due to their personal benefits, miserly, misleading or bad company, they waste their power of accepting the truth slowly and gradually. So, it is our duty that with the power of seeking the truth which we have in our hearts, naturally, we should not let it be destroyed, but remain in search of the just and the truth. We should publicize the teachings of the truth and convey the message of truth to the servants of God with such wisdom and in a graceful manner that fear of God and softness may be produced in their hearts who have a little ability to accept the truth. We should approach unto them with our possible available resources. Urdu mein samaat farmayi, kafir. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. BisMIllaahir-Rahmaanir-Rahiim. Innal-laziina kafaruu sawaaa alay-him anzartahum amlam tunzirhum la yu'minun. Beshak jo log kafir hain, barabar hai un par. Kha tu unhein rahe ya na rahe, wo iman nahi layenge. Kafaruu, jo inkaar karte hain. Ye lafz kufr se nikla hai jiske maani hain chupana. Shariat mein kafir use kehte hain jo haq ka munkar aur mukhalif ho, Allah aur uske rasool sallallahu alaihi wasallam ko na manta ho. Allah taala ne jab falah hasil karne wale muttaqiyon ka haal aur unki kamyabiyon ka zikr farmaya hai to zaruri hai ke munkaron aur kafiron ka haal aur anjaam bhi bayan kiya jaye taaki dono ka farq wazeh ho jaye aur parhezgaron aur nekokaron ka martaba roshan ho jaye. Is ayat se aise logon ka zikr shuru hua jo imaan walon ke bilkul zidd waqe hue hain, dil se islam ke dushman hain, apna waqt quwwat aur daulat gharz har cheez uski mukhalifat mein sarf karte hain. Aise log daleelein samne aane ke bawajood kufr par ade rehte hain. Haq qubool karne ki istidaad musalsal inkaar aur mukhalifat ke baais kamzor hoti jati hai, yahan tak ke bilkul khatam ho jati hai. Is surat mein nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam ka unke liye azab se darana ya na darana barabar hai. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam ki sabse badi arzoo ye thi ke sab log islam ke daire mein dakhil ho jaye. Is ayat mein aap sallallahu alaihi wasallam ko ye haqeeqat batayi gayi hai ke aap sallallahu alaihi wasallam ka kuch kare ye haq ko pehchanne aur manne ki quwwat zaya kar chuke hain. Ye jo kaha gaya hai ke rasool pak sallallahu alaihi wasallam unhe drahe ya na drahe, wo imaan nahi layenge, ye khabar faisle ki surat mein nahi hai balki unke musalsal inkaar aur mukhalifat ke natije ka izhar aur elan hai. Allah taala ne har shakhs mein haq qubool karne ki salahiyat rakhi hai, lekin jo log zati faydon ko taa nazri, غلط تعلیم یا بری صحبت کی وجہ سے سچائی کی مخالفت کرتے ہیں ان میں حق قبول کرنے کی قوت رفتہ رفتہ باقی نہیں رہتی. اس لیے ہمارا یہ فرض ہے کہ تلاش حق کی جو قوت ہمارے اندر فطری طور پر موجود ہے اس کو ضائع نہ ہونے دیں, ہمیشہ حق اور صداقت کی جستجو میں لگے رہیں. ہمیں چاہیے کہ حق کی تعلیم عام کریں اور اس خوش اسلوبی اور حکمت سے حق کا پیغام اللہ کے بندوں تک پہنچائیں کہ ان کے دلوں میں نرمی اور خوف خدا پیدا ہو. جن میں تھوڑی سی بھی حق کو قبول کرنے کی استعداد موجود ہے ان تک اپنے ہر ممکن وسائل سے پہنچیں. صدق اللہ مولانا العظیم و صدق رسولہ النبی الامی الکریم.